The manuscript is really extraordinary and bizarre. If you just leaf through this facsimile we have here, it's written on vellum, which is animal skin, and it's roughly coloured and rather amateurish.
Tucked inside the pages, Voynich found an old letter. It's the first clue for any investigator trying to understand the meaning and origin of the manuscript. The letter revealed that the Jesuits had owned the book for 250 years and had been trying to decipher the strange text and identify the bizarre illustrations.
The manuscript was sent to a scientist and linguist, Athanasius Kircher, hoping that he would throw some light on what the manuscript was about.
Kircher was a leading Jesuit scholar, one of the greatest of all time. And the Jesuits, who count the current Pope among their number, are renowned as the intellectuals of the Catholic Church, determined in their pursuit of knowledge.
It's a mysterious book. It's the type of thing that would have enthralled Kircher. He was fascinated by everything.
In 1912, Wilfried Voynich found an ancient manuscript written in a bizarre code. He also discovered a letter with the book. Written in 1666, it reveals one of the previous owners had a theory about its author, a potentially vital clue to the book's meaning.
The said book belonged to the Emperor Rudolf. He believed the author was Roger Bacon, the Englishman.
Roger Bacon was a 13th century monk with a fascination for alchemy, the attempt to turn ordinary metals into gold. The church considered it heresy.
Roger Bacon was always treading in that area. There's a possibility that the whole Voynich manuscript is secrets of alchemy. So the assumption was for Voynich that Bacon might well have had to mask any of his researches and therefore put it into cipher.
Cryptographer Gordon Rugg, who has a detailed knowledge of medieval cipher techniques, is not convinced.
Leading modern code breakers have run the text of the Voynich manuscript through software, and then they've looked for patterns every 10, 20, 40 characters, and they've found nothing.
If the book is written in code, it is more advanced than anything modern computers and expert code breakers can unlock. A feat that seems impossible with the techniques available to Roger Bacon. What if there is another explanation? That the text is not a code at all, but simply has no meaning? Gordon Rugg believes there was a powerful motive to do just that.
In the Middle Ages, books of wonders were worth a lot. I think it's almost certainly a hoax. Hoaxing the Voynich manuscript for money would make excellent sense.
There is evidence to support this theory. In the letter Voynich found with the manuscript is a reference to one very wealthy owner of the book.
The said book belonged to the Emperor Rudolf, and that he presented to the bearer who bought the book 600 ducats.
Rudolf II was the Holy Roman Emperor. He was obsessed with the occult and was a tempting target for any hoaxers. Even 600 ducats, £50,000 today, would be a small price for him to pay for the manuscript if he believed it contained the encrypted secrets of alchemy. Prime suspects in this hoax theory are John Dee and Edward Kelly, two Englishmen involved in the scheme to turn copper into gold. Kelly was in Prague, the capital of the Holy Roman Empire, in the 1590s when Rudolf reigned. Could he and Dee have hoaxed the manuscript to sell to the emperor? To test the likelihood of this theory, scientists at the University of Arizona carbon-dated samples of the animal skin, or vellum, the manuscript was written on. Carbon dating is a powerful tool in the quest to solve ancient mysteries. By measuring the decay of radioactive carbon-14, it can determine the age of organic matter, like the vellum of the manuscript. Would it determine a date of the manuscript and add weight to the theory that it was a 1590s hoax?
Well, we dated 4 vellum pages distributed throughout the book and found that all 4 of those pages had very tightly clustered radiocarbon dates. And the radiocarbon age is 1404 AD to 1438 AD at 95% confidence.
This carbon dating evidence blows away the idea that Dee and Kelly hoaxed the manuscript. It was written over 100 years before they were born. So the Voynich manuscript appears a genuine mystery. In his mission to decipher it, Jerry Kennedy tries one final approach and takes a closer look at its strange illustrations.
The biggest section is rare-looking plants, but they are incredibly bizarre, very strange-looking things.
Jerry takes a copy of the manuscript to Kew Gardens in London, an internationally renowned centre of botanical research. It has over 30,000 living plants, the world's largest collection. If Kew scientists can identify the plants in the manuscript, it might reveal its meaning and origin.
This almost looks like it's grafted onto the base of the plant, but you wouldn't in nature see anything happening like that. So I think you can safely say that these are plants of invention rather than real plants.
Look like nothing on Earth.
Look like nothing on Earth.
The plants look like no species known to man, but there's something else otherworldly amongst the illustrations.
There's also a section which one would want to call sort of cosmological or astrological. There's a spiral that some people have said clearly must be Andromeda.
Andromeda is a spiral galaxy. It's the closest one to Earth's and bears a striking resemblance to the Voynich diagram. Yet it is millions of light years away. Its spiral shape is only visible with modern high-powered telescopes. This technology didn't exist when the Voynich manuscript was written in the early 15th century. How could anyone on Earth draw a galaxy we had yet to discover?
It appears as if there must be some underlying sense to it.